Dear Elise, lately we haven't seen much of each other. I hope you're keeping well. How's your daddy and your mother? I hope they're just as happy as I saw them in the summer. Just as warm and just as full of color. And healthy too. Convey my best to little Elsie too. And by the way, Shawn tells me that you're teaching at the Chelsea school. That's the other address that I've had this letter sent to. But forget that, I'm so glad you're doing what you're meant to. You've always been a great mentor. I'm not being flattering, I'm being frank when I'm saying if it hadn't been for your advice and letters, I would have went bonkers by the end of college. Knowing you sent them was my only solace. I think about what happened in August, like all the time. Took me ages to follow my better nature, swallow pride, and acknowledge the fact that the entire fault was mine. All the lies that let colonize my mind, it was all surmise. I let them compromise my virtue. To apologize in ink would not suffice, but I'm sorry I hurt you. Anyway, I'm going away for a while. I've been signed to the RAF, eagerly awaiting your reply, Michael. To me an eternity ago, and Chester seems like a distant dream that I yearn to see again. I never heard from you, my letter mustn't have gotten through, and I've been busy, but don't you think that I've forgotten you? I've become a pilot in the service officially now, and while it's true I was slightly nervous initially, I would be lying if I told you that flying's not an epiphany, and that you wouldn't look at life a bit differently. Playing hide and seek with clouds up in the sky, looking down at all the towns that are seemingly stuck in time. For a moment, you blissfully forget the pain and the cries. The poet awaits, you ask yourself, who painted the skies? Who painted the skies blue? Shoot, I wish I knew. And onward goes your train of thought, until you find your serenity tainted by the occasional vague shadow, or enemy silhouette distrained on the play clatter. I've sensed the onset of the concept of the war, and I've told this to no one because it would cause them to start viewing me as a coward. But between you and me as of now, I find myself asking how I'm the only one unable to venture into war with a sense of adventure. Maybe I simply don't possess their penchant for danger. Lately I've started to find myself greatly conflicted. I'm not convinced we're justified in the pain we've inflicted. On a brighter note, I picked up an interest in poetry. Believe it or not, supposedly strenuous job as piloting is, there's plenty of time to pen you a song. Hoping to hear from you, Elise, faithfully yours, Michael.
Colder, every order I follow. With every bomb dropped, my plane carries more weight. I don't know what's harder to swallow. That I may die tomorrow, or live with the tale. Colder, every order I follow. With every bomb drop, my plane carries more weight. I don't know what's harder to swallow. That I may die tomorrow, or live with the tale.
Dear Elise, I'm hoping that this letter never finds you. If it does, well, then it's the last I'll ever write you. Since this letter will only be used after my death, it may seem macabre at best, but I have to request that you do not view it as such. For I've slowly come to believe that death is only a release from the bodily crutch. I'd written this after the message made bombing in Dunkirk, and even though I've come to terms with the constant uncertainty at work, this is really the first time that I wondered if I might actually have to leave without saying goodbye. Even though you've been so long out of my sight, know that you have stayed in my mind till the day that I die. I wish that you and I had more time to spend together. I squandered what little I had, being juvenile, this I will regret forever. Funny, if I'm set for heaven, it won't be the first that I'm watching the earth from above. In such a war as this, there really is no right and wrong. But if there's anything worth fighting for, it's to save our children from the frightening dogma in the Nazi system of control that would paralyze their minds and sterilize their souls. I believe that this war will end in a victory, and better days are coming. Vienna will sing again. Soon this will all be forgotten pages in history. It's been an honor being your friend. Someday we'll meet again. Till then, goodbye.